Linda. How do you want me to say it? I have been telling you to stop jumping from one relationship to another. It is not a good thing to do. It is unscriptural.
Why will I not jump from one relationship to another when all the men that come my way, none of them is my class?
What do you mean by all the men that come your way are not your class?
Mother, you have heard me right. Those men that come my way are not in my class.
Don't you know that it is in your place to sit down and pray to God for what you want?
What does prayers got to do with this? It is in my place to go for what I want, not to sit down and pray. I am not a child.
Linda, you are talking nonsense. Matthew 7:7 says, keep on asking, and you will receive what you ask for. Then John 16:24 says, ask, using my name, and you will receive, and you will have abundant joy. 1 John 5:14-15 says, and we are confident that he hears us whenever we ask for anything that pleases him. He told you that God cannot give you whatever you ask him, in his name. You may think getting into another relationship will make you feel better, but in reality, what you are really doing is giving away a broken heart to another candidate. It's a bleeding heart, unfit for the services that come with being in a relationship. Since your heart is not yet healed, any mistake, error, or flaw this person makes, or has, as they handle your heart, will cause premature infliction. This is the third relationship that you have, under 1 year. First, it was Mr. Martin's. Second, it was Barrister John. Now you are going out with another man. Have you listened to yourself? Is that how a responsible lady should behave? Do you know that you are in a community where people are watching all that you do?
Let them watch, for all I don't care.
Hi, damsel.
Welcome, sir.
You look pretty in your pink colored dress.
Thanks for the compliment. You look handsome as well, in your black suit.
What is your name?
My name is Linda. And you?
My name is Gabriel. What can I offer you?
Anything you give me will be highly appreciated. Whatever please you will please me. What is it? Why are you staring at me like that?
Linda. Yes, I am in love with you. In short, I love you.
I pray, may it come from your heart.
So, you have accepted me, just like that?
Yes, I have accepted you.
Oh no, I am super excited. You are one of the simplest lady, cheap, easygoing lady.
Me. Cheap.
I am not saying that you are a cheap girl. What I mean there's that, you are an easy and simple lady.
Now, that you are talking. I thought you call me a cheap girl.
No. How can I be saying that?
So, what do you do for a living?
I am a tailor by my profession.
A tailor? It's okay for you.
What do you mean it is okay for you? You should have said, it is okay for two of us. Since you have accepted me, and you want me to come see your parent, for your hand in marriage.
No. That was not what I meant. God forbid. Me marry to a mere tailor. No. It can never work. I am a big girl. I am looking for my own class. I must keep on jumping from one man to another until I see a man that I want. I did not come to life to suffer. That means the man package himself, like a big man, all my hope, I was thinking he is a big fish. Not knowing that, he is packaging himself. He cannot even spend money for my drink, Now you want to come see my parent for my hand in marriage. Linda, you have seen something. Nonsense. I am a tailor. Do I look like a tailor's wife? Nonsense.
Hello viewers. You are welcome to another interesting video on emanimations. Thank you for always being supportive to this channel. For my old subscribers, my prayers is that, may God supply all your needs according to His riches in glory, Amen. To the people that watch without subscribing, may you be richly blessed, in Jesus' name. Breakups happen, relationships and friendships can end, abruptly, and for different reasons. It's what we do, after the breakup, that can either spoil, or edify our love lives. After a breakup, you will inevitably, face a crossroad, that influences you to either remain single, and heal, or get into, a new relationship with a new person, or back to the example. Have you ever cut yourself, by mistake, or fallen down? Remember, how painful washing the wound is, or, putting any kind of salt, ointment, balm, or, even a bandage, seems to increase the pain? Yet, this processing of dressing the wound, is done to aid healing, to take place. You see, the majority of times, relationship hopping can happen, when one is afraid of being alone. It becomes an antidote for dealing with reality. The reality being facing, and enduring the painful process of healing, from a heartbreak. Are you jumping from relationship today? In 1 year you have dated, or been in a relationship with 2, 3, 4, 5 plus different people? Maybe you are just in relationships for the sake of having someone? Being in a relationship with someone cannot save you, only Jesus Christ saves, hence, a relationship with another individual is simply the evidence of two people coming together in agreement, to date, or, to court. You may think getting into another relationship will make you feel better, but in reality, what you are really doing, is giving away a broken heart to another candidate. It's a bleeding heart, unfit for the services, that come with being in a relationship. Stay tuned.
Sweetie, what's up?
Yeah, I am cool. And you?
I am fine. Please, can we talk?
Yes, we can talk.
What is your name?
My name is Linda. And you?
I am Don. Some people call me Money Man.
Wow. What a sweet name. Money Man. I so much love the name. Let us have a sit, so that we can discuss.
What can I offer you? Anything you want, I am ready to pay. As the matter of fact, let me go tell barman to arrange some drinks for us. Barman, please, I don't have money. If that girl asks you for any drink, tell her that the drinks has finished.
You mean the lady that came with you?
Oh no, I am super excited. This is the type of man that I am looking for, Money Man. This is a big fish that I am catching. This man looks like money. From his head, to his toe, his is a complete man.
Sweetie, I have talked to him, maybe, it is like they don't have the types of wines, that we want.
No, how can that be? This is the popular Joe's Corner, where assorted wines, and drinks, are being sold. Maybe I will see him myself. Barman, do you have, Heineken?
No, we don't have.
What of Star Radler?
It has finished.
What do you have? Because my friend wants to buy me some drinks.
We are ordering for new drinks. They have not yet brought them.
Baby. There are no drinks here.
I told you that they don't have drinks.
Baby. What are you doing for a living?
I am an international oil worker.
Wow. What a good work. That work is good for both of us.
Yes. It is good for both of us.
Oh no. I am super excited. What a big catch. I have seen the type of man that I wanted. the money man. Thank you, Jesus, for answering my prayer. He is an international oil worker. This is the type of man I was looking for. The Bible says that we should knock, for it will be opened. Seek, and we shall find. This is exactly what the Bible is talking about. Not to stay at be praying. I am now the wife of the money man. Mother, I am super excited.
What is that? Super excited about what? Tell me, what is going on?
I told you not to worry about me. That one day, I will see the man of my class. My husband-to-be is an international oil worker. He is a cute, handsome, and a caring man. I met him at Joe's Corner, one of the popular drinking place. I am super excited.
Galatians 5:16 says, "Then, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusts against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another, so that you do not do the things that you wish." Ephesians 5:15 says, "Be careful then how you live, not as unwise people but as wise, making the most of the time, because the days are evil. So do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is." Jumping from one relationship to another is not the right thing to do. For our God, who resides in heaven, is able to supply all your need. Sit down and pray to God for the right man or woman to come. Then, at the appointed time, it shall come to pass. Instead of jumping from one relationship to another and cause pains to the other persons.
Jesus Christ, Mr. Money Man, are you a taxi driver?
Ugh. Let me explain.
Explain what? Do you know what your lies has caused to me? After telling my people that my husband-to-be is an international oil worker. Oh no, this man has finished me. What type of nonsense is this? You are the worst man that I have met in my life.
Baby, let me explain. I can explain.
What do you want to explain when have lied to me that you are an international oil worker? Not knowing that you are a mere taxi driver. What else do you have to say? You disgust me. I hate you. You are a fool.
Finally, these are dangers of jumping from one relationship to another. Number one is, you limit the ability to completely heal. Being in a relationship with someone cannot save you, only Jesus Christ saves. Hence, a relationship with another individual is simply the evidence of two people coming together in agreement to date or to court. You may think getting into another relationship will make you feel better, but in reality, what you are really doing is giving away a broken heart to another candidate. It's a bleeding heart, unfit for the services that come with being in a relationship. Since your heart is not yet healed, any mistake, error, or flaw this person makes, or has, as they handle your heart will cause premature infliction. What this means is that your heart will be extra sensitive and easily offended, which in turn may give you an ugly attitude and appearance. Evidence of this ugliness is through continuous emotions of jealousy, short temper, insecurities, grudges, bitterness, and a need to control the other person. A broken heart is not capable of loving at such a capacity. It takes a whole heart to love in such a way, and more importantly, a whole heart that is submitted to Christ's love. The second danger is, you disarm the privilege of total healing when you hop into another relationship quickly. Healing on the job can be very dangerous. People who enter relationships too soon and decide to heal from previous hurts whilst in a new relationship are indirectly derailing their virtues and blessings. In the sense that they can't fully enjoy what they have when they are still dealing with past hurts. Whether a relationship was sexual or non-sexual, when two people break up, It causes a tearing of hearts because of an emotional soul tie that would have developed. Emotional soul ties are inevitable in relationships, and each time you confess your love towards each other, that emotional bond becomes tighter and tighter. It's very crucial that your heart is mended before another emotional soul tie is formed with another, otherwise, this will birth a dysfunctional relationship with the new candidate. The third danger is, creates unrealistic expectations. When broken people enter a relationship, their expectations can often be driven by fear, hence, making them unrealistic. Such people are often searching for a savior through the candidate they are dating to save them from the past relationship. It's important to know that humans are fallible. They cannot be perfect because only God is perfect. Hence, it's always wise to look at your beloved through the eyes of Christ, seeing as they are flesh and are capable of causing you offense. This does not mean they should abuse, cheat, and violate the boundaries of a healthy relationship. It simply means that he/she may do or say things you may not really like. Please note, when there is abuse, unfaithfulness, and manipulations, these are signs of serious dysfunction in your relationship. Please do not settle. And finally, it births a spirit of divorce. When you are constantly breaking up with people, this can limit your ability to be sensitive to the sacredness of love. Love is very sacred and needs to be understood with maturity. The problem nowadays is that people are entering relationships for the sake of it. Sometimes, to please people, please themselves, follow trends, to mask an image, or look popular. A relationship that doesn't lead to marriage is a waste of time. I hope you have been touched by this video. Thanks for your time. Bye.